Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum. Dear students, today our topic is sodium carbonate, which is also known as washing soda, soda ash, and soda crystals. Na2CO3, which is the formula of sodium carbonate, is the water soluble sodium salt of carbonic acid. It is most commonly occur as a crystalline heptahydrate, which is radially efflorescence to form a white powder, the monohydrate. Pure sodium carbonate is a white odorless powder that is hygroscopic. It has strongly alkaline taste and form a moderately basic solution in water. Sodium carbonate is well known domestically for its everyday use as water softener. It can be extracted from the ashes of many plants growing in sodium-rich soils, such as vegetation from the Middle East, calip from Scotland, and seaweed from Spain. Because the ashes of these sodium-rich plants were noticeably different from ashes of timber used to create potash, they become known as soda ash. It is synthetically produced in large quantities from salt, sodium chloride, and limestone by a method known as Solvay process. Dear students, in the introduction, he said that sodium carbonate is known as washing soda, soda ash, and soda crystals. Sodium carbonate is the soluble salt of carbonic acid. He also said that sodium carbonate is commonly exist in the heptahydrate form. It means it will include 7 molecules of water, which effloresces and form a colorless powder of monohydrate crystals. Then he said that the pure form of sodium carbonate is a white odorless powder, which is hygroscopic. Hygroscopic means it will absorb moisture from the air. And then he said that sodium carbonate is a alkaline compound or has alkaline taste and form basic solution, moderate basic solution in water. Then he said that sodium carbonate can be extracted from the weeds or from the timber of different plants which grow in the sodium rich soils, like vegetations which grow in the Middle East, calip which grow in the Scotland, and different seaweeds which grow in the Spain. We can extract sodium carbonate from all of these. And he also said that the ashes which obtained from the vegetations, from the calip and the seaweeds are very different from the ash of that timber which is used for the potash. So for this reason, we said that sodium carbonate is also known as soda ash. And at the end, he said that sodium carbonate can be prepared synthetically by the process which is known as Solvay process. In this process, we use sodium chloride and limestone for the production of sodium carbonate. So this was the short introduction where we have said that sodium carbonate, or where we have discussed the existence of sodium carbonate and nature of sodium carbonate, then from where we can extract the sodium carbonate, and how can we prepare sodium carbonate synthetically? Dear students, after the discussion of short introduction, now there is the occurrence of sodium carbonate. Sodium carbonate crystallizes from water to form different types of hydrate. Sodium carbonate decahydrate, sodium carbonate heptahydrate, sodium carbonate monohydrate. In first point, he said that sodium carbonate crystallizes from water. It will form different form of its crystals. Now, what are these forms? First one is sodium carbonate decahydrate, which is known as natron. This form of sodium carbonate include 10 molecules of water. And the next one is sodium carbonate heptahydrate, which is not known in mineral form. This form will include 7 molecules of water. And the last one type is sodium carbonate monohydrate, which is also known as thermonatrite. And this form will include only single molecule of water. Now, the next point is sodium carbonate is soluble in water and can occur naturally in arid regions, especially in mineral deposit formed when seasonal lakes evaporate. Deposits of mineral natron have been mined from dry lakes bottoms in Egypt since ancient times, when natron was used in the preparation of mummies and in the early manufacture of glass. Dear students, in this point, we said that sodium carbonate in the form of natron is mined from the dry lakes of Egypt from the ancient time, when Egyptians used sodium carbonate for the preparation of mummies and glass. So, till now, we have discussed 2 points. First one was sodium carbonate can be crystallized from water in 3 different types. And then we have said that sodium carbonate can be mined from different dry lakes like in the Egypt. From the ancient time, Egyptians used sodium carbonate for the production of mummies and glass. Now the next point is the anhydrous mineral form of sodium carbonate is quite rare and called nitrite. Sodium carbonate also erupts from Daimyo Lingui, Tanzania's unique volcano, and it is presumed to have erupted from other volcanoes in the past. But due to these mineral instability at the Earth's surface, are likely to be eroded. all three mineralogical forms of sodium carbonate as well as trona, trisodium hydrogen dicarbonate dihydrate, also known from ultra alkaline pigmatic rocks that occur, for example, in the Kola Peninsula in Russia. Students, after the discussion of introduction of sodium carbonate and occurrence of sodium carbonate, now we are going to discuss production of sodium carbonate. And in production, first of all, is mining. And in mining, we will discuss from where sodium carbonate is mined. Trona, which is trisodium hydrogen dicarbonate dehydrate, whose formula is Na3HCO3CO3.2H2O, is mined in several areas of US and provides nearly all the domestic consumption of sodium carbonate. Large natural deposits found in 1938, such as one near Green River, Wyoming, have made mining more economical than industrial production in North America. There are important reserves of trona in Turkey. 2 million tons of soda ash have been extracted from reserves near Ankara. It is also mined from some alkaline lakes such as Lake Magadi in Kenya by dredging. Hot saline spring continuously replenish salt in the lake so that, provided the rate of dredging is no greater than the replenishment rate, the source is fully sustainable. So student, this was mining, in which we have discussed that the sodium carbonate is extracted from Green River, from North America areas, from Lake Magadi, and from the different reserves in Turkey. Students, we are discussing production of sodium carbonate, and in the production we have discussed mining. Now we are going to discuss Brilla and Caleb, where we will discuss how can we extract sodium carbonate from different seaweeds and vegetations. Several halophyte plant species and seaweed species can be processed to yield an impure form of sodium carbonate, and these sources predominated in Europe and elsewhere until the 19th century. Dear students, he is telling the first method of extraction of sodium carbonate from different plants. He said that the plant species were processed, and then after their processing, sodium carbonate is extracted from these processed plants in impure form. He said that this method was predominated source of sodium carbonate till 19th century in Europe and different areas of the world. After the 19th century, the next method was introduced, which was that method, or this method was the land plants, typically glassworts and saltworts or seaweeds like Brilla and Caleb, were harvested, dried and burned. These ashes were then lexivated to form an alkali solution. This alkali solution was boiled dry to create the final product, which was termed as soda ash. This very old name referred to the archetypal plant source for the soda ash, which was the small annual shrub Salsola soda. Dear students, the next method for the harvest or for the extraction of sodium carbonate is, first of all, harvest the civet or plant cipici, then dry them and burn them. After their burning, the ash were collected and lexivated with the water. And alkali solution was made. That alkali solution were boiled and dried to fine powder. That fine powder is known as soda ash. This name was given due to the annual shrub, which is known as Salsola soda. This is the scientific name of Brilla plant. So student, in this point, we have discussed two points of extraction of sodium carbonate, in which first one was the processing of plant cipici or the salt plant and extraction of sodium carbonate. And in the second method, we have discussed that the plant cipici were harvested, dried, and then burned. And burned, after their burning, the ash were collected, washed with water, and converted into alkali solution. That alkali solution is boiled and dried to fine powder, which is known as soda ash. And that name is given to it for the extraction from the plant, which is known as Salsola soda. And commonly, it is known as Brilla plant. And the next point is, sodium carbonate concentration in soda ash varied very widely from 2-3% for civet dried from Kalem to 30% for the best Brilla produced from the saltwort plant in Spain. Plant and civet source of soda ash and also for the related alkali potash become increasingly inadequate by the end of 18th century. And the search for the commercially viable route to synthesize the soda ash from the salt and other chemical intensified. Dear students, he said that sodium carbonate concentration changed from 2-3% from the civet dried from the Kalem and the 30% which was dried from the Brilla. Dear student, in this point, he also said that this method was replaced by different methods in which sodium carbonate was synthetically produced by the use of salt and different chemicals. Dear students, after the discussion of extraction of sodium carbonate from different plants, now we are going to discuss how the mine form of sodium carbonate is purified, or how the mined crystalline form of sodium carbonate is purified. And in that route, the first one is Prona purification process. Several processes are used to refine Prona ore and are more simpler than solvent process. Dear students, when we are discussing the introduction, we have said that we use Salve process for the synthetically production of sodium carbonate. Now, he said that there are several methods which are commonly being used for the purification of trona, which are simpler than Salve process. In general, they are of two types. In one process, trona ore is calcined to impure soda ash, which is then purified. The other type of production is that produce soda ash by calcination of purified sodium sesquicarbonate obtained from the trona. The first route is now used predominantly, although the later used route was practiced first. Dear students, in this he discussed just two points. He said that there are two methods for the purification of trona. In first one, trona ore is calcined to impure soda ash, which is then purified. And in second one, there is the production of soda ash by the calcination of purified sodium sesquicarbonate, which is obtained from trona. He said that the first route is more oftenly used as compared to second one. So students, so far we have discussed trona can be purified by the two ways. In first one, the trona ore is calcined to impure soda ash, and in the second one is sodium carbonate is produced by the calcination of sodium sesquicarbonate, which is obtained from the trona. Now the next one is monohydrate process. In this process, trona ore is crushed and then calcined in a rotary kiln at 160 to 200 degrees centigrade. Decomposing the sodium sesquicarbonate and liberating water and carbon dioxide. Students, in the monohydrate processing, the trona is crushed and calcined in rotary kiln and heated at the temperature of 160 to 200 degrees centigrade, which decomposes the sodium sesquicarbonate into monohydrate and liberate water and carbon dioxide. The calcined material, which is impure soda ash, is agitated in tanks with water or weak soda ash liquids to dissolve the soda ash and soluble impurities such as sodium chloride and sodium sulfate. Insoluble material consisting of shale, clay and complex salts containing calcium carbonate is separated from the hot near saturated soda ash solution. To reduce soda ash losses, waste solids from this step were washed before being discarded. So students, in first point, we have said that when we heat trona at 160-200 degrees centigrade, sodium sesquicarbonate is decomposed. Water and carbon dioxide both are liberated. Now, that calcined material is agitated in tanks with the weak soda ash liquor or water. Why this is agitated in tanks with weak soda ash or water? The answer is to dissolve soluble impurities and soda ash. And the insoluble impurities, which include clay, shales, and complexes, were separated and washed before the discardage. This is the monohydrate processing, in which we have discussed the trona is cursed calcinate and heated at 160 to 200 degrees centigrade. Sodium sesquicarbonate carbonate is decomposed and liberate carbon dioxide and water. Now that calcinate material is then agitated in tanks with water or weak soda ash liquor to dissolve sodium carbonate and soluble impurities. And insoluble impurities are separated and discarded after the washing. So students, now in the mother liquor, we just have the soluble impurities, because insoluble impurities were discarded. Now, what will we do to obtain pure form of soda ash? For this, the first point is, the filter liquor is usually treated with activated carbon to remove soluble organic compounds and reduce foaming during evaporation to produce crystals of sodium carbonate monohydrate. Now, what is said in this point? After the removal of insoluble impurities, now it's time to remove the soluble impurities. For this purpose, we treat mother liquor with activated carbon, which remove organic compounds, and it reduces foaming agent, because the organic compounds produce foaming agent in the production of crystals. When it is removed, then there will be fine crystals of sodium carbonate. If anyone asks, how can you remove soluble organic compounds from your mother liquor, then you will answer that by treating our mother liquor with the activated carbon, we can remove soluble impurities and also can decrease the foaming agent. And the next point is, crystallization is carried out in the multiple effect evaporators at maximum temperature of 100, which is below the transition temperature of monohydrate to anhydrous soda ash. And then after the removal of organic impurities, then the mother liquor is crystallized about 100 degrees centigrade. After that, a purge from the crystallizer may be maintained to remove impurities. The slurry is centrifuged to separate the crystalline sodium carbonate monohydrate from the mother liquor, which is returned to the crystallizer. The monohydrate crystals are dehydrated at about 150 degrees centigrade because the crystal size of soda ash is carefully controlled in the crystallizer. Only nominal screening is required before the dense soda ash product is cooled and loaded. dear student, in this point, he said that by the centrifuge, we can separate our crystals from the mother liquor. And those crystals were dehydrated at 150 degrees centigrade. And the sizes controlled carefully. So in the production, dear students, we have discussed different points in which we have discussed that trona is cursed and calcinate, then heated about 200 degrees centigrade. That calcinate is agitated with soda ash liquor or water to dissolve soluble impurities and soda ash. That solution is now then treated with activated carbon to remove organic impurities and then crystallize about 100 degrees centigrade. After that, the crystals were separated from the mother liquor by the centrifuge, and then monohydrate is dehydrated about 150 degrees centigrade and its crystals are controlled carefully. After the discussion of monohydrate process, now we are going to discuss how sodium sesquicarbonate carbonate is processed. In this route, the first point is, in this process, the cursed trona ore is fed into a series of dissolves to produce a saturated mother liquor, which is clarified, filtered, and freed from organic compounds by carbon treatment. Here, all the process is same. Here, the cursed trona is passed from different dissolves where saturated mother liquor is prepared, insoluble impurities are removed, and organic impurities were also removed. Now, what will happen to next? Cryon of the equipment of the mother liquor is controlled by the low concentration of sulfide ion. The treated liquor is evaporated in vacuum crystallizers and cooled to 40 degrees centigrade. The sodium sesquicarbonate carbonate crystals formed are centrifuged and the mother liquor recycled to the dissolvers. The sodium sesquicarbonate carbonate crystals are decomposed to the sodium carbonate in the rotatory calibers approximately at 200 degrees centigrade. This point is similar to the monohydrate processing, in which the crystals are separated from the mother liquor by the centrifuge. Here, the crystals were also separated from the mother liquor by the centrifuge process. And the last point is, the anhydrous soda ash product has a bulk density of about 800 kilogram per meter cube and must be double calcinated to prepare dense ash. After calcinations, the soda ash is cooled and is ready for the shipment. So dear students, these four points were discussing the sodium sesquicarbonate carbonate processing, which were similar to the monohydrate processing. So far, dear students, we have discussed how sodium carbonate is extracted from different plants and how sodium carbonate is mined and its different ores were processed and how these ores are converted into sodium carbonate. Now, we are going to discuss how we can prepare sodium carbonate in industry, or synthetically how can we prepare sodium carbonate? And in that route, the first method is dual process. In this process, ammonium chloride is produced as a co-product in equivalent quantities and differs from conventional solvent process. It does not recycle ammonia. Beta G, in dual process, along with sodium carbonate, there is the production of ammonium chloride. As you know that ammonium chloride is a very excellent fertilizer. But in the solvent process, that ammonium chloride is not produced. If anyone asks, what is the difference between the solvent process and dual process, you can say that in the dual process, there is the production of ammonium chloride. But in the solvent production, there is not production of ammonium chloride, because in the solvent process there is not recycle of ammonia. Now, what is dual process? We are going to discuss in detail. The mother liquor from the carbonating system containing ammonium chloride, unreacted salt and traces of carbonate is ammoniated in ammonia absorber. That ammoniated mother liquor is passed through a bed of salt in the salt dissolver. Exit liquor from the dissolver saturated with salt, gradually cooled from 40 degree to 10 degree by evaporation under vacuum to separate ammonium chloride. The slurry containing ammonium chloride is centrifuged and dried. The product is 90% pure and is marked as ammonium chloride fertilizer and nitrogen content of 25%. Dear student, in this process, the mother liquor from the carbonating tower containing ammonium chloride and unreacted salts with the traces of carbonate is ammoniated in ammonia absorber. What it means? Mother liquor which contain ammonium chloride and different traces of salts and carbonates is ammoniated in ammonia absorber. Then that ammoniated mother liquor is passed through the salt bed, which is salt dissolver, and then it is exited from that salt dissolver saturated with salt, that is gradually cooled from 40 degree to 10 degree under the vacuum to separate ammonium chloride. That slurry which contains ammonium chloride is centrifuged. The product is 98% pure and marked as ammonium chloride, which contains 25% ammonium chloride. Clear ho gaya? If it is not clear, then I am going to repeat it again. Mother liquor which contains ammonium chloride and different salts and carbonate is fed into ammonia absorber where it is ammoniated. Then it is passed through the bed of salts or salt dissolver, and that mother liquor is exit saturated with the salt. That is cooled gradually from 40 to 10 degrees centigrade in the vacuum to separate ammonium chloride. That slurry is then centrifuged. Ammonium chloride is separated. That ammonium chloride which is separated has 98% pure form of ammonium chloride, which contain 25% nitrogen. As the slurry was centrifuged and ammonium chloride was separated from the mother liquid, then what will happen to that mother liquid we are going to discuss now. The mother liquid obtained after the separation of ammonium chloride crystals is recycled to the carbonation vessel placed in series. That mother liquid is recycled to the carbonation tower, where there are different vessels like pipe were placed in series. Then carbon dioxide obtained from ammonia plant and the calciner section of soda ash plant is injected in the carbonation vessels. There is provision of cooling coils in the lower carbonation vessel. Sodium bicarbonate is formed. So what it means, the mother liquor is then fed into the carbonation vessels, and in that those vessels the carbon dioxide is passed through it, and that carbon dioxide which passed through it convert it into sodium bicarbonate, and that sodium bicarbonate is then will be converted into the sodium carbonate, how now we will discuss. The growth of crystals of sodium bicarbonate is controlled by the supply of cooling water to the cooling water coils in the carbonation vessels. Sodium carbonate is thickened in the thickener and centrifuged. The sodium bicarbonate is calcined to the soda ash. He said that the crystals of sodium bicarbonate you can control by the provision of water for the cooling pipes, and that sodium bicarbonate and then calcined and converted into the sodium carbonate. So this was the dual process in which you have to prepare ammonium chloride and sodium carbonate. Here is raw material consumption per ton of co-product. Salt 1.3 tons, ammonia 335 kgs, power 250 kWh, fuel oil 18 liters, steam including refrigeration must be 2.5 tons. The plant has several advantages over the conventional solvay process, in much as it is used less raw material, has no effluent disposal problem, and both sodium and chloride residual of salt are fully utilized and giving valuable ammonium as byproduct. In this point, he said that that dual process has several advantages over the conventional solvay process because it uses less raw material and there is no problem or there is no disposal of byproducts because both of the byproducts are being used for the production of ammonium salt, which is used as fertilizer. So dear student, this was the dual process for the production of sodium bicarbonate.